Everyone, I hope you all will be fine. So let's start our today's session. So in our today's session, I have brought the new topic for you, that is metallurgy of copper. So you see here the first point which I have written for you, that you have to understand whenever we plot a graph between delta G and T, it shows that Cu2O that is present almost at the top. Okay, so it shows that it is easily to reduce by carbon and carbon monoxide in the range of 500 to 600 Kelvin. So here is an understandable point that is very important for you. Copper ore most probably that is present in the form of sulfide. So in the term of sulfide ore, what is the process is to be followed, that in terms of concentration, that is to be of froth flotation process. Okay. So copper sulfide ore is to be concentrated with the help of froth flotation process. In concentration, we have removed all the lighter impurities, and after that, what is to be done? We have to do the process of roasting, that is also is to be done in the terms of sulfide ore to convert into a metal oxide. In this process, metal sulfide is to be heated in presence of oxygen or in presence of air, that will convert into a metal oxide. After getting a metal oxide, we have to convert into a free metal, so we have to do the process of reduction. So Cu2O is treated with the carbon, that will convert into a free copper. Okay, so that the next point which you have to understand, this is of smelting. The ore is mixed with SiO2, this is a sand, and heated in reverberatory furnace, that you can call it, this is a oven, and this is a place where we can create a large temperature. Iron oxide reacts with SiO2 to form iron silicate in the form of slag. FeO that reacts with SiO2, FeSiO3 is formed, in that converts into a slag. Okay, that brings out some impurities also. Now after that, copper is produced in the form of copper mate. This is the combination of Cu2S and FeS. It is charged into the silica lined converter. Some silica is also added and hot blast air is to be blown inside the converter. Okay, now after that, what is to be done? That will helpful to convert iron sulfide to iron oxide, Cu2S, Cu2O to a free metallic copper. Now you have to see what the chemical reactions will take place. FeS reacts with oxygen, that will convert into iron oxide. FeO reacts with SiO2, that will convert into FeSiO3, that is a form of slag. Now Cu2S reacts with oxygen, that will convert into Cu2O, SO2 gas comes out. This Cu2O act as autocatalyst. Once again it will react with Cu2S, that will convert into 6Cu, that is a free copper, and SO2 gas comes out. Here you have to understand the one important point, the solidified copper obtained in the form of blister. Blister means that is in the form of uneven surface. Why does it happen? Because SO2 gas evolved. Actually in the sulfide ore, what is present? Sulfur gas is present, and sulfur is present, that comes out in the form of SO2 gas. Suppose this is a sheet of copper, and SO2 gas is escaping out, so it create an uneven surface, that we call it copper blister. Okay, now after that, the process of refining is to be done. Refining that we have to do in the term of metallurgy of copper, that is of electrolytic refining, and everybody knows that what we have to do in this procedure, that I have explained in the last lecture. Okay, we have to take a big container, we have to take a rod of impure copper and the pure copper. Pure copper will act as cathode, impure copper will act as anode. They, after passing electric current, then what will happen with the help of electrolyte, the pure copper from impure metallic rod, that will start to deposit around the pure copper, and impurities will fall down, that we call it anode mud. And two chemical reactions will take place. One will be at anode, on anode oxidation will take place, copper will get oxidized, and at cathode, copper ion, that will reduce to a free copper, that will convert into a free copper, and that will be impurity free. And what are the impurities that can be present in a copper? That is to be of antimony, selenium, tellurium, silver, gold and platinum. Okay, now the next point that you have to understand, how we can get a free copper from a low grade ore. Low grade ore, you can call it, this is a scrap, means some other metal content will be present inside it. So what is to be done in this process? The process of hydrometallurgy is to be done. Actually, what is to be done in hydrometallurgy? few acids are to be used and some bacterias are to be applied on it. So whenever we are using here the some chemical as a solvent, so the process is to be come in the category of leaching also. Okay, so that's why we call it is leached out. Okay, now copper ion that reacts with H2 that will convert into a free copper. Here cupric ion will react with Fe that will convert into a free copper. This is a impurity free copper that we get at the last in the term of metallurgy of copper, which we will do in the terms of low grade copper ore. Okay, I think you all have got it. That's all for today.